Stop playing. You ain't see that. Stop playing. You just told me about it. My dad bought it for me. I got me a purchase. I didn't know about the comp.
Jake, do you have anybody walking you out? Like any famous singer?
I had like five people walking me out, but I can't because of COVID. Because LA is so strict. So no one's even allowed in my locker room. But I was going to have some dope people walk me out. But
I guess straight out of London, right?
Fresh out of London. I got a new song dropping.
Okay, let's tell everybody.
On Wednesday, Park South Freestyle, music video, November 25th. So this coming Wednesday, be ready. It's fire. That's my best one yet. So we're just taking over, baby. You
got Mac in the house.
What's up, Ellie? Oregon.
Did you find the restaurant last night? You were looking for one.
Which one?
You said anybody could recommend the restaurant?
We went to Musashi's.
Hey, who gets more trolls in their life? You or BJ?
I think BJ.
Why do you attract all the trolls?
Just, I don't know why.
I think the kids like me, man.
They like me. Like, what's up, Jabba? What's up?
They like Jay Leon. They do. Yeah. I think I'm a little older and I call shit how I see it, and people don't always appreciate that. So
they were coming at you in waves with fake accounts and everything.
It's all right. It's no problem. It's all part of it. So you know, as long as Jake's backing up what he's got to do in the ring, it doesn't matter to me. I don't care. I'm not worried about the haters.
Yeah.
Haters can hate until they're asking you for jobs.
That's right.
Hey. Yeah, bro.
They troll him because he's allergic to bullshit.
Yeah.
See, BJ Flores is allergic to bullshit.
That's true.
He's always been a blue collar worker, come to work with his hard hat and his lunch pail, whoop ass, and go home.
That's it, baby.
That's all it's ever been about. One thing about haters, they'll see you walking on water and they'll say it's only because you don't know how to swim.
That's Mac.
That's clean right there. That's nice. I mean, you can't deny it. So. Mm. It's very good.
But this is exciting. Mike Tyson coming back. That's history. Like, who would not want to watch Muhammad Ali fight one more time?
And who would not want to watch Sugar Ray Leonard, Al Bernstein, and one of the best MMA fighters?
Israel Adesanya.
I can't say his last name. How do you say
Adesanya.
Adesanya, yeah.
You got it.
Who's not going to want to watch those guys, you know, calling the action? So it's going to be great. I'm really excited about it.
All music, too.
It's going to be sick. It's going to be great.
Yeah. Lil Wayne.
BJ, you have a lot of celebrity friends. A lot. A lot of them are hitting you up right now about this fight.
A lot of who? I'm sorry?
Celebrity friends.
No, not really too much. They know I've been busy, and, you know, they just wanted to know if they can come, and now everyone kind of knows they can't. But we're going to have a big viewing party at the house in California, so people will be able to come over there and watch the fight and kind of celebrate afterwards, and that's it. So I'm mainly, it's all fun and games, but I'm focused on the fight. I want to make sure Jake goes out and performs and does everything he's supposed to do, starting with the left hand, so I know that's going to work out and stay focused on that. So.
I got to ask you this. Today you posted on Twitter, Instagram, your story, 60-40 split for Spence, and you said it was fair, correct?
Yeah, I mean, he's the one who sold all the pay-per-view buys. I mean, he's the one who sold over 300,000 when he fought Garcia.
Mikey?
He's the one who sold over 300,000 when he fought Mike. Yeah, Mikey and Porter. So he's the one that's really brought the business so far, and Terrence hasn't, but even though he's a very good fighter.
But it will be a big fight. I hope we get to see it. But first, there's Danny Garcia, Earl Spence.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I mean, I think it's going to be a very tough fight, very tough fight. So I think people are underestimating Danny. I think Danny's played this role a couple times. He's going to be ready. I think he's going to come in well, and I think anything less than 100% from Errol Spence, it's going to make a real tough night for him. But they're both good friends of mine. They're both great champions, so I'm looking forward to it.
You fought with a lot of different promotions and promoters. You had a very great career champion. Canelo was with Golden Boy and The Zone, took a step back, left Golden Boy back in The Zone. What do you make of that?
I don't even want to get into that. I don't even know where to start. Could be a lawsuit coming from Golden Boy. You know.
No. I think they settled it. It sounds like.
I really don't know. Like, I mean, somewhere. Like, he wasn't with The Zone. He's with The Zone. Then he breaks from Monster. Now he's back fighting on The Zone again against Callum Smith. Is that right?
Yep. So tough fight.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, he's a tough kid. And he's big. He presents a lot of you know, physical obstacles for
Canelo.
For Canelo, yeah. So it's going to be a tough fight for him.
But we want to see that. We want to see Benavidez and Plant and all those big ones.
Benavidez is the one I really want to see. So, yeah.
Who wins that one, Benavidez or Canelo?
I can't, man, Benavidez needs a little more experience right now. But within a couple of years, I mean, I wouldn't pick against him on anybody. So,
you know him since he was a kid in Phoenix, right?
Yeah, I did. And then, but you know, just being in there with him and sparring with him is a lot different than seeing him on camera. He's a dog. And Caleb Plant, I mean, you can never pick against that guy either. So they're two great up and coming fighters and very focused fighters. So I think this is going to be a great matchup.
And BJ, I've watched Jake Paul trained for a couple years.
Yeah.
He looks like he has the form better, the speed better, the power better. When you do mix with him, how hard does he hit?
He hits hard. He punches really well. So
it's God-given.
That's kind of a thing that I don't really like to talk about much. Yeah. So I want people to be surprised when they get in there. But I talk about his fundamentals and his skills, and people think, oh, you know, he doesn't punch hard. But as soon as people get touched by him, they definitely feel it. And, you know, he's a good puncher.
We saw it with Gibb. And
yeah.
What's your prediction for Nate Robinson?
Oh, it's going to be a knockout, 100%. But we're not looking for the knockout. It's just going to come organically, and it's a testament of what Jake's done over the last 3 years, but more importantly, within the last year, he's really learned how to box. He knows how to stay on his back foot, how to go on his front foot. He knows how to punch like a pro, punches with his legs, uses his body for his punches. He uses his jab excellently. He knows how to go up and down with it, change levels. He knows how to slip, counter. A lot of things he's added on in the last 11 months that are going to make Nate's short night very difficult.
Introduces here to my right.
Yeah. We got I Pick Wins over here.
What's
Zach
up? What's
Hirsch, a buddy of mine. He just got hired on with the Impact Network and doing reporting with them. And him and his father have been friends of mine for a little while. He comes out and trains with me. We do some work working on his boxing stuff, and he also does the bare knuckle stuff too, right?
Yeah, bare knuckle fighting championship. I do all their odds.
Okay.
For them.
Let me really quick, Zach, for all the viewers, how should they bet Mike Tyson, Roy Jones? Give him one tip for free.
Mike Tyson by finish, because I think that's the way he's going to win. You know, if it goes the distance, I think you got Roy, and I think if it's a knockout, you got Mike Tyson, so you parlay Mike by finish. I think that's the move. If you think Roy, you go Roy, and you go the rounds, you go over, right?
I think Roy can win by finish, too. I think Mike hasn't taken out a punch in 18 years, and I feel like 18 years of smoking weed, and, you know, it catches up with you, trust me. Like, I don't care what anybody
okay.
says, but
we see Nate Diaz.
BJ's the boxing expert. You're the betting expert. So you guys are telling two different stories right here. He says Mike Tyson might knock out Roy, so just watch the
can
fight.
I say one thing about the weed. I've seen these two brothers, the Diaz brothers. They're zombies. They smoke more weed than anyone, and you can't finish them.
They're
so
not
I
zombies.
I think the weed... They're in the ring, you can hit them, they don't go down.
They're not 57 years old.
Yeah.
Big difference.
54,
yeah. Big difference.
The weed might make your chin better, though. Big
okay, difference. So there we have it.
It doesn't make your lungs better either.
BJ Flores Pro
they got
on
more
Instagram.
Than anyone.
Zach, tell them where to follow you.
You can follow me on Instagram at iPickWins or on my website, iPickWins.com.
All right, follow him and be responsible. Don't bet your life saving. Be smart.
Bet
no.
it all.
That's yeah.
All.
Stay tuned. Elie Seckbach reporting. I got it. Yeah, of course.
Let's go.
I'm ready, baby.
Okay. Who beats Logan Paul better, Jake or Floyd Mayweather?
Oh, man. That's a pretty tough first question right there. I mean, Floyd is Floyd. I mean, but nothing to do with Jake and Logan. I don't even want to talk about Jake and Logan too much. It's not really a fight we're even thinking about. If it happens down the road, it happens. But right now, we're focused on Nate Robinson.
Tell me about camp. He looks in shape. He looks focused. Good energy.
He's ready. He's been ready for about probably 4 months now. We've just been like pulling him back and doing some very sharp sparring, very good sparring with a lot of good pros here in Vegas. That's why he came to Vegas. And he's ready to put a show on the road.
You know, a lot of people, I go to a lot of gyms, I talk to people on the phone. When I posted the video, I shared a video of him sparring. They said, Elie, he's not sparring real fighters. I said, yes,
yeah.
he is. Tell
yeah,
him,
yes.
BJ. Tell him.
Well, we don't really post the real fighters that he's sparring. A couple guys that come in to talk, we'll let him spar those guys, get him out of there and around. But he's been sparring a lot of real fighters. And
we don't
post
it's
that kind of stuff. People will see though November 28th.
What's up, baby?
What do you tell him?
It's
not fight week. It's not fight week.
It's not fight week, guys. Next week's fight week.
Go ahead.
It will be fight week. It will be.
Soon enough. Everyone calm down.
That's how we feel.
Nate Robinson, what do you tell him?
You know, like I said, I respect Nate. You know, training this entire time coming in. I'm sure he's working hard. He's a professional athlete, but this is different. You know, it's tough to come into boxing when you're 36 years old. So I just want to make sure he shows up, gives his best effort, and, you know, made the best man win.
It's good. So, BJ, what do you tell all the fans about the pay-per-view? Mike Tyson, Roy Jones, Nate Robinson against Jake Paul.
Yeah. It's a legendary card, bro. It really is. I found out Al Bernstein, Sugar Ray Leonard, and what's his name? The MMA fighter. They're all doing the commentary. I can't say his last name very good.
Israel Adesanya.
It's just an amazing team of guys who are amazing team of guys who are going to be calling the action. Ray's been a good friend of mine for a long time. Fight's going to be on the Triller app, November 28th. A great undercard with Vidal Riley, and you also got Badu Jack, and separate fights. Mike Tyson, Roy Jones Jr., Jake Paul, Nate Robinson. It's a card you're not going to want to miss. Check it out.
You know what tripped me out today? I saw a big poster. Jake Paul co-main event.
Yeah.
That's huge.
Yeah, man. He's doing okay. We're getting there. So, you know, he's got a lot of influence, and, you know, he's taking this very seriously. So he's ready to put on a show, and November 28th, that's exactly what we're going to do.
There you have it. DJ Flores, where do people follow you, DJ?
DJ Flores Pro. Thank you.
Setback. What's good?
Bro, Forty, what's up?
What's the deal, baby?
Well, like, introduce everybody that's here.
Man, you got John.
You got D-Cut.
Hold on, let me really get you. This is John. Listen, makes all this shit happen. Puts it all together, man. I mean, the dude has a vision like no other. You got D-Cut. You know what I'm saying? Listen, I can talk all day about D-Cut. D-Cut, man, listen, he's a battery, bro. He's the battery to everybody's energy, everybody's everything. You feel me?
That's good. That's the hype, man.
You got Carl.
Oh my God.
I thought it was KSI for a second.
No, Carl is one of a kind.
Listen, when we slip up, he catches up. You feel me? So that's it. Obviously, DJ, this is the boss, man. Listen, let me tell you something, man. You got a lot of trainers out here, but this is my first time really getting an in-depth experience with him in the ring and his knowledge. Motherfuckers could be the baddest trainer in the world, no question. Real talk, you already know. And the rest is just, that's it, man, this is it. And then you got me, you know what I mean? You got Jay, I'm
Jay
just
I
here.
Love.
You feel me?
You and Travis Jr., right?
I'm with it, listen. Let's get it, I'm ready. You know what I'm saying? I ain't in bad shape. Let's get it, baby. Let's get it.
So tell me about the fight. Jake Paul, Nate Robinson.
Look, it's a fight. You know what I mean? We respect both guys for getting in there. YouTube, former NBA, whatever you want to say. Obviously, you got people that have a lot of different views about it, but it's a fight, and it's going to be entertaining. Jake Paul has been taking the game serious. Obviously, Nate has been taking the game serious. So these guys are going to come in and bring their viewership and their fans into a realm of our sport, and let's see how it works out, man. And
you've been in camp with Mayweather for many years with a lot of big legends. How hard is Jake Paul working for this fight, just work-wise, ethic?
Oh, like no other, man. Like, that was my thing. From when I first came in, he's been taking this shit so serious. I mean, this kid is already successful. He don't have to be in here getting punched in the face. He can be riding in Cali and Calabasas and Lambo and living his life the way he wants to. But he's here putting in work, dedicating himself. Obviously, the team is doing the same. And that's what it is.
You can feel the energy. Let me move out of the way. They're about to film.
For sure, man. It's lit. That's what it is. It's lit, man.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.